Hi, welcome to Ken's Games Collection and my continuing countdown of my top 10 games of all time. And coming in at number 4 is Detroit Become Human. I got this game back in 2019, I think it was, and paid like $23 for it. I was really skeptical going into this game because I know in the works that Quantic Dream had done in the past, Fahrenheit, which I haven't played yet, but Heavenly Rain and Beyond Two Souls, which I did play. I really wanted to get into this genre, but it's very limited gameplay, and you can go back to Dragon Lair, Night Trap, all of those games, Psychic Detective, which was on the PlayStation. Very limited gameplay. It was all like watching full motion videos where you just react to certain events, and that's what this genre is, and that's what Detroit Become Human is. But I can see what the team was doing. You know, you look at Heavenly Rain, Beyond Two Souls, they were building and building and building to something amazing, and Detroit Become Human was phenomenal. And like I said, I was really skeptical when I got into this. What's really interesting about Detroit Become Human, it does revolve around three artificial intelligence, Connor, Marcus, and Kira. And I've got to say, going into this, in the back of my mind, I'm always thinking about artificial intelligence, just how far this technology has come. And we're at the stage now where AI is already a reality in some ways. It's not fully there yet, and when that day does come, God help us, I really believe that. So when you look at humanoid robots like Sophia, and there's one in Japan which looks so real-like, but particularly with Sophia, I've seen stories and seen stuff on YouTube about this android, the artificial intelligence, her talking to celebrities, being on talk shows, and just recently she's been dabbling in art and sold like $700,000 worth of art, and now is going to embark on a music career, which is crazy. I think she's even been sanctioned by a country, maybe Switzerland or something, that she has rights. But that's getting off topic. But I was thinking about this sort of stuff when I started playing Detroit Become Human, about even Skynet. You know, we joke about the Terminator movies and Skynet, the day that artificial intelligence takes over, and sadly we are heading in that direction. I feel I've seen stuff on YouTube with those military robots, you've seen all that sort of craziness which is sort of coming into reality now, and that, like I said, that was always in my back of my mind when I started playing Detroit Become Human. The way it's written is so amazing with the characters, and that opening scene where you're in the lift with Connor, you come out into this apartment and there's a fish laying on the floor. The tank is up on the wall, and you have this choice to either leave it or pick it up. And I said to myself when I started playing this game, I was gonna think as the androids would. But what's the first thing I do? A human trait. I picked up the fish, I got Connor to pick up the fish and put it in back into the fish tank. And I kind of started messing, that one act messed with a bit of his programming, which is really important because Connor's, the interactions you have with Connor really has a major impact on the story and how things play out for the other characters, because he's the most advanced AI in this game. But I think it was beautifully written with an amazing cast of actors and actresses portraying these characters, and especially with Connor, Marcus, and Kira. It was just such an amazing thing to see, because that's the only way I can say it, because I was so involved with this. And even though all it is you got your controller, you push a button to interact with certain people, with what's your next line of dialogue is going to be, or you're pushing a button, moving a directional controller to do actions. And that's pretty much all it is with the gameplay. But the story was so engrossing that it just dragged me in further and further in. Those opening scenes sort of starts out slow, but then it builds and builds and builds until something incredible happens, and I found myself feeling sorry, feeling empathy for these androids and what they were going through, and that's, I guess that's a human trait that we have. I think that's what the writers were trying to convey as we go from thinking of these things as just androids to the end where I nuke Detroit for the androids. That was the ending I decided with Marcus. I nuked Detroit, which was crazy. I got to that stage where I felt more and more and more involved with the androids and the human race, which is scary enough. But this was an incredible game, incredible experience, I guess you could say. I wouldn't call it so much of a game. It was an experience that I just couldn't put down. And every time I come home from work, I had to go back to play this game. And you could play through this game about 5 times because of the flowchart. Decisions made really do make a difference in this game. And you can play it through the second time and have a whole new experience from the first one. And there's still stuff on the flowchart that I still haven't explored, and I know I can go through at least another 2 times playing this game. And you go through the different flowcharts, and it's going to be a totally different experience again. And that's what I really enjoyed about this game. It's something that I can go back to. I'm going through another gameplay now. Before I chose what was coming at number 4, I played a few games, and this one always was in the back of my mind, and I could see why when I went and replayed it. It was just a fantastic game that I think everybody needs to experience. Even if you're not used to this genre, just give it a go, because I can guarantee you, you're going to be sitting there in your chair, you know, just doing the actions, but you're going to be so engrossed in the story. And that's what this is all about. It's got amazing visuals. They did a great job on the visuals in this game. And the storytelling is brilliant. The voice acting with all these characters is amazing. And even some of the characters in the game, like Marcus, looks like the real life actor. Kira looks like the real life actress in this game that portrays their voices. So it's something that really grabbed my attention. And if a game like this can do it, that with limited gameplay can get you thinking, can get you so involved in it and wanting to go back and replaying it more and more, it does deserve to be in my top 10 games of all time. So that's what's coming at number 4 is Detroit Become Human. Incredible game. It really is. And I hope everybody gets to experience it and just open up yourself to what is a roller coaster of a ride. It really is brilliant. Until next time, guys. Bye.